Hello everybody, I am Baljit Dhaka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today we are going to discuss paper code 890. This is Tarvan test series. Question number 51. In the given figures, the length of side ABC, this is ABC, and PQR, this is PQR, ABC and PQR. You can see these are similar triangle. And they are given in the same units. Also A and B are given. A and B are given. The value of P would be, we have to find the value of P. Now why similar, these are similar triangle? Because this is analogous to this. And this is analogous to this. You can say from this, if you reverse it, you will find like this. And 6 is equal to 12. It means if it is 80 and 60, then it would be equal to, which is equal to this. So it would be equal to 40. It means this would be equal to 40. This would be equal to 40 because this 80 and 60. So answer in this case would be 40. D is the option. Question number 52. Tangent square theta plus secant theta plus 1 is minus secant theta is equal to. Now put value, for example, let's put for simplicity reason value theta is equal to 45. You can put any other value and you will get the same answer. So tangent 45, that is tangent theta is equal to 1. So 1 square, and when theta is 45, then secant would be root 2 plus 1. So you can say if you rationalize it, you will get root 2 minus 1, because you will rationalize like this, root 2 minus 1 and root 2 minus 1, a plus b, a minus b, so a square minus b square, you will get 2 minus 1, that is 1. So ultimately you will get this equal to root 2 minus 1, and secant theta is equal to root 2. So root 2 cancel, you will get answer minus 1. Answer is C. Question 53. A empty pool being filled with water at a constant rate takes 8 hours to fill 3 by 5 of its capacity. How much more time will it take to finish the pooling? You can say to fill 3 by 5, it will take 8 hours. To fill 2 by 5, it will take, you can say 8 divided by 3 by 5, 3 by 5, and to fill 2 by 5, you will have 16 by 3 means you can convert it into 65 hour 20 minutes. C is the answer. It means 16 by 3, which is equal to 5 plus 1 by 3 hours. 1 by 3 hours means 20 minutes. 5 hour 20 minutes. Answer is C. Question number 4. In this question it is given, by selling an article rupees 450, a man loses 10%. The gain or loss percentage if he sells it for 540. So 440 into 100 by 90, this is selling price. This is cost price, because selling price is this. If the loss is 10%, then cost price would be equal to this. You can say cost price is 500 rupees. Cost price is 500 rupees. Again, he want to sell at 540. It means he is earning 40 rupees. 40 rupees is profit on 500. On 100, it would be equal to 8%. Because this is the cost price and profit is 40, 40 rupees profit on 500, then on 100 it will be 8%. Question number 55. Sum of the ages of two brothers having a difference of 8 years between them will double after 10 years. What is the ratio of the age of the younger brother to that of the elder brother? So what is the interpretation of this question? For example, this is younger brother and elder brother is x plus 8, if younger brother is x, and after 10 years, it means you add 20, 10 year older brother, 10 year elder brother, 10 year younger brother, total would be 20 years, which is equal to x plus 8, that is sum of the age of two brother into 2, which will be equal to this. So understand from this question, interpretation is the is this: sum of the two ages of two brother multiplied by 2 is equal to x plus 8 plus 20. This is the equation. Now you can say 2x plus 28, and this is 2x plus x, that is 4x, 4x plus 16. In other words, 2x you can say 12, 2x you can say 12, x is equal to 6. So x is the age of younger brother, 6 is, and then elder brother would be 6 plus 8, that is 14. Younger brother, elder brother, 6 plus 8. So ratio is 3 is to 7, answer is C. Next question, question number 56. Average age of A, B and C is 84 years. When D joins, then the average age become 80 years. A new person E, whose age is 4 years more than D, replaces A, and the average of a B, C, D and E becomes 78 years. What is the age of a A? What is the age of a A? Now see, A, B, C, total age would be equal to 84 into 3, 252 will be the total age of A plus B plus C, because average is 84. When D joins, it means A plus B plus C plus D, then average age becomes 80 into 4, that is 320. 80 into 4, that is 320. It means D age would be the difference of ABCD minus ABC would be the, now it would be 320 minus 252, that is 20 and 48, 68. Age E, a new person E whose age is 4 years more than D, it means E age would be 68 plus 4, 72 is the age of E. Replace A, and the average age of B, C, D, E becomes, so B, C, D and E, average age is 78, total age would be multiplied 4, 312. You can write here 312. So you can say A, B, C, D. Average age is A, B, C, D. In this, you will find A, B, C, D is 320. And A plus B plus C plus B plus C plus D, E is equal to 312. So here in this, it is given A, B, C, D 320 and E 72. So A, B, C, D would be equal to A, B, C, D plus E is equal to 320 plus E, 72. 320 plus 72, 392. A, B, C, D, E, 392. B, C, D, E, 312. Then A, difference of these two would be age of A. 392 minus 312, that is 80. A is equal to 80. Answer is D. Next question, question number 57. The compound interest on rupees 1800 at the 10% per annum for a certain period of time is 378. Find the time in year. It means 378 plus 1800, it would be equal to 1178 is the amount, total amount. Amount is equal to principal plus simple interest, compound interest, that is 2178, which is equal to P, that is 1800, 1 plus R by 100, that is 10 by 100 into T. T is the time which we have to find. So you can say it will go by 18. 121 by 100, which is equal to 11 by 10 power 2, is equal to, this is equal to 11 by 10, 1 plus 1 by 10, that is 11 by 10, and is equal to T. So when the base is same, T is equal to 2, time is 2 years. Next question, question number 58. The ratio of the two numbers is 3 is to 4 and their LCM is 180. Second number would be how much? So these are two numbers, 3x and 4x, and LCM would be equal to, you can say 4, 3, 12, 12x. 12x is total LCM. 12x is equal to 180, x is equal to 180 by 12, that is 15. Answer is, what is the second number? Second number is 4x, so 14, 15 into 4, that is 60. बी शुड बी द आंसर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 59. इफ पी इज 99 देन द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस एक्सप्रेशन, दिस इज इक्वल टू पी 3, 3p 2 प्लस 3p, एंड यू नो पी प्लस 1 क्यूब इज इक्वल टू पी 3 प्लस 1 power 3 प्लस 3p इंटू 1 एंड p प्लस 1. इट मीन्स पी 3 प्लस 1 प्लस 3p स्क्वेयर एंड प्लस 3p, बट हेयर वी हैव गिवन दिस. इट मीन्स इफ आई दिस इज प्लस देन आई पुट हेयर माइनस 1 देन इट विल बी इक्वल टू दिस. इन अदर वर्ड्स दिस इज इक्वल टू पी प्लस 1 क्यूब एंड माइनस 1 हेयर वी कैन पुट देन इट विल बिकम दिस. It will become this. So p plus 1 we have given 90 plus 1 100. 100 power 3, that is this, minus 1. You will have this answer, 999999. 2, this is equal to, you can say 2, 2, 2, 6. Then here we will have is 7 digit, means here we will have 6 digit. 3, 3 plus 6, 6 digit we have. Next question, question number 60. The speed of the current is 5 km/h. Speed of current is 5 km/h. A motorbike goes 10 km upstream and back again to the starting point in 50 minutes. The speed in kilometer per hour of the motorbike in still water. So 50 minutes is total time. It means 5/6 hour you can say. And 10 km the distance. So 10 km divided by still water, let's take x. And 5 km is the speed of current, that is current speed. So distance divided by upstream distance divided by downstream is equal to 5/6 hour total. Now this would become quadratic equation, but in place of that you should always try to put value from the option C, option which can be fulfill the value. We have to find 5/6 which is equal to 1/2 into 1/3. How can become 1/3 when we will have here 25? It means 25 minus 5, that is 20. 10/20, that is 1/2. And 25 plus 5, 30. So 10/30 is equal to 1/3. So 25 should be the answer. Question number 61. If I walk at 5 km/h, I miss a train by 7 minutes. However, if I walk at 6 km/h, I reach the station 5 minutes before the departure of the train. Distance between my house and the station would be how much? In such kind of question, you can take LCM. Let's say total distance 5 or 6 LCM, that would be 30 km, let's say total distance. It means to cover 30 km, and if I walk 5 km/h, I will take a 6 hour. And if I go by 6 km/h, then I will take a 5 hour to cover 60 km, 5 hours. So the difference is 6 hour and 5 hour, that is 1 hour, means 60 minute is the difference. Then distance is 30 kilometer, but here the actual difference is 7 minute and 5 minute. 7 minute he was late, and earlier here 7 minute he reached earlier. It means difference is 12 minute. So 60 minute is representing 30 kilometer, and 12 minute will represent 30/60 × 12. You can say 6 km is the distance, total distance from home to station. So answer is D. Next question, question number 62. What is the question? A gun is fired at a distance of 1.34 km from Gita. See, hear the sound after 4 seconds. Speed at which sound travel is. It means 1.34 km, that is 1340 meter. And that distance is travel in 4 seconds. It means three three five should be the answer. Question number, answer is B. Just we have divided in 4 seconds. 1340 kilometers is traveling in 1 second. How much travel? Question number 63. The length of the shadow of a tower is 9 meter. This is tower. This is length of the shadow. 9 meter when the sun altitude is 30. And when that said is 9, we have to find the value of h. We have to find the value, what is the height of the tower? We have to find the value of h. So h by 9 is equal to tangent 30, which is equal to root 3. So h is equal to 9 by root 3. But you will find question always, you have to rationalize it. You have to rationalize it. That is 3 root 3. 3 root 3 is the answer. Always in such kind of question, you have to rationalize it. On decreasing each side of an equilateral triangle by 2 centimeter, by 2 centimeter, there is a decrease of 4 root 3 centimeter square in its area. In its area, the length of each side of the triangle would be how much? So, let's suppose earlier the side is A. So, area would be 3 by 4 A square. Now, the distance, length is decreased by 2 centimeter. That is root 3 by 4 A minus 2. Instead of 2, it will become A minus 2. So, this is area, this is new area. The difference would be 4 root 3. This is the equation. Earlier area, now this area, the difference is 4 root 3. This is the equation that we are drawing from this. So root 3 a, root 3 you can, 4 you can take common. So you will have a square minus here, you can open this bracket, for example a minus 2 whole square, then you will find a square plus 4 minus 2 into 2, 2a into 2, that is 4a. But here this is a sign of minus, so everything you write opposite, change the sign. You will hear in place of plus, you write here minus a square. In place of 4, you write minus 4. In place of minus 4, you write 4a. And that is equal to 4 root 3. So root 3 cancel. You can write a square cancel. So 4a, this is 4a. 4a is equal to 16. 4a is equal to 16. And this 16, this would be plus when we will it go this side. So 20, a would be equal to 5. It means, what is the question? Length of each side of the triangle. We have to find the value of a, which is equal to 5. Next question, question number 65. What is the question? Find the least number which when divided by 12, 18, 36, 45, leaves the remainder 8, 14, 32 and 41. So the difference between these always is, here we can see 4. So take the LCM of these and then 2 minus 4, you will get the answer. But here you will find, instead of that you can directly take the minimum value, that is 176, and divide it by 12, it will be the remainder is 8. Now to verify, you can also take another, for example, let's take 18. So 18 into 9, 162. So the difference is 14. It means 176 is the right answer. Otherwise, you can take LCM minus 4. Next question, question number 66. Tangent theta plus cot theta is equal to 2. Here theta, when we have theta is 45, it means tangent 45 would be equal to 1, cot 45 is equal to 1, 1 plus 1 would be 2. It means from this we can find that theta is equal to 45. Answer is C. Next question, question number 67. Area of the iron sheet required to prepare a cone 24 cm with the base radius 7 cm. We have to find this is cone, and we have to find what is the area to make this cone, entire cone means total surface area. Total surface area is equal to pi r l plus, this is curved surface area, and plus pi r square. Why pi r square? This is the area of the base, we have to find this also. Now the radius is 7, height is 24, 7, 24, 25, these are triplet, means 7 square plus 24 square is equal to 25 square. You have to memorize few important triplets. I have told many times 7, 24, 25. This is very, very simple. Now we have find the value of L. This is slant height, which is 25. Now take common pi r, 22 by 7, r is equal to 7 l, l plus r we have to find. So l plus r would be, l is now 25 and r is 7, 25 plus 7, 32. You can write directly 32 because this is 25 and this is 7. So it would be 32. You can say 22 into 32 would be equal to 704. This is total surface area. Answer is D. Question number 68. The shadow of a tower standing on a level ground is found to be 40 meter longer than when the sun's altitude is 30 degree than when it is 60 degree. It means what is he is saying? That this is 30 degree, this is 60 degree altitude, and the shadow difference is 40 meter. We have to find the value of length of the tower. This is h. So this is 60 degree, this is 30 degree, this is the d, which is equal to 40 degree. I have told this short trick, which is very very important, because almost 80% of the question is based on this trick in height and distance. And what is this trick? D is equal to h quote theta 1 and quote theta 2, higher value and lower value. Here in this case, root 3 minus 1 by root 3, higher value, lower value. Root 3 minus 1 by root 3 is always equal to 2 by root 3. Cot 30, that is root 3 minus 1 by root 3, cot 60. So which is equal to 2 root 3, and we have to find the value of height. So into h, d is equal to given 40. You can say h is equal to root 20 root 3. Answer is A. Question number 69. Height of the two similar right angle triangles LMN and OPQ are 48 cm and 36 cm. This is, for example, these are two triangles. One is LMN, L, M and N. The second is O, P and Q. And height is 48 and 36. This is 48 and 36. And these are two similar triangles, remember this. So he is saying that if OP is 12, instead of 36 it is 12, then what will be this? So 12 into 3, that is 36. It means 48 divided by 3, that is 16. 16 to 3, 48. So the ratio is, you can say this, you can think like this, 48, 36. If this is 12, then this would be equal to how much? It means answer is 16. B should be the answer. This is a similar angle triangle property. Question number 17. A merchant prices 10% off on the item bought from his store. Total discount got by a customer who bought a cooker worth 650, a heater worth 500 and big bag worth 65 rupees. So on 650 he is getting 10% discount, that is 65 rupees. On 500, 10% at the rate of 10% it means he is getting 50 rupees. On 65 at the rate of 10% he is getting 6.5 rupees, 6.5 rupees. In other words, 121.50 is the total discount that the customer is getting. Answer is A. Question number 71. P can do a piece of work in 9 days. Q is 50% more efficient than P. Q is efficient. In other words, Q will take less time. Q will take a less time. Number of days it takes for Q. So 50% efficient means if A is, one is doing, P is taking in one day doing 2 units, then Q will do 3 units. In other words, you can also say that if P is doing in 3 days, Q will do in 2 days. This is the ratio of days and this is the ratio of their efficiency. So days ratio, it means 2 by 3 into 9, you can say 6 days. In 6 days, Q will do the work. The question number 72. What is the question? In this question, it is given. The histogram shows the mark obtained by 45 students of a class. Look at the histogram and answer the question. This is the histogram. 10, that is, you can say number of students till 10 marks. 2, another 6, let's mark it 10, 8, 7, and this is 3, 4, 5. What is the question? How many students have obtained mark 50 and above? So mark 50 and above, you can say 4 plus 7, 11 plus 5, 16. Answer is D. Next question, question number 73. What is the question? If the pass mark be 30, what is the number of failure? How many students were failed? It means first three column. This is L30, but the pass mark is 30, but they have no, and this three column would represent failure, and which is equal to, you can say 6 plus 2, 8 plus 10, 18. 18 should be the answer. Answer is B. B, you can say 2, 6 and 10. Next question, question number 74. What is this question? If the pass mark be 30, what is the percentage of successful student? This is 30. Then these are, it means these are successful. And successful students are 3, 3 plus 8, 11, plus 4, 11 plus 4, 15 plus 20, 7, 22, 22 plus 5, 27. 27 students pass out of 45, because total students are 45. Percentage would be equal to, you can say 20 into 3, 60% number of students pass. Percentage student pass. How many students have obtained marks less than 10? Less than 10, that is, this is 2 students obtained less than 10. So answer is A. So in this way, we have covered all 75, till 75 questions. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.